wig friends, Nikki here. Welcome back to my channel. I've got the wig cap on. I'm bringing you a wig review. But before I get into those specifics, just want to mention, I originally was making a video today of me creating this eye look for you. Obviously, it didn't work out. So if that's something you would like me to redo, put it down in the comments and I will happily do that. I also happily do take requests. So if there's a wig you'd like me to review, let me know. And while you're down there, let me know what you think of this wig, since I'm going to be telling you everything you need to know. I do upload every Monday, Thursday, and Friday, plus surprise days also. So if you have already subscribed, thank you so much. Welcome back. If you haven't yet, join the party already. Otherwise, you're going to miss everything that I have got coming. Today, I have got another wig from Vivica A. Fox. I just recently reviewed Jarrett. And today, I have got Gemini. She is also a lace front with kinecalon fibers. I have her in the color FS4/30. She does come in a few other colors. She has undetectable and resilient soft Swiss lace, a pure stretch cap, and is heat safe 356 to 392 degrees Fahrenheit. I picked her up from sogoodbb for $37.99. And here is Gemini. She looks like she's going to be another cutie. I could tell from those photos. You can have some fun with her. So she does have a bit of darker tinted lace, which is fine. I think I can still work with that. Let me just flip the cap inside out. We can get a better look at what's going on. She's got a curved parting space. She also has a one comb over here on the side, and then there's one comb here up near the part. This is the reason why I don't like big spaces between the wefts. This can happen. I don't know how it happened because I haven't done anything with her yet, but oh well, it's there. She does also have a comb here in the back along with adjustable straps. And obviously you can see what this lining is like. She also has that stretch cap, so it's going to be larger head friendly. Look at all that stretchability she has. You know the drill, guys. If you don't, I'm going to go put her on and come back with my final thoughts. Okay, guys, what do you think of Gemini? I'll be honest, I'm a little torn on her. I have mixed feelings, basically. My husband, however, really likes her. So at least that's positive. I just don't know if she's really right style for me, though. But I know she is the right style for someone else. So even though I will talk about my personal preferences, it's still really the quality that I'm most interested in and I'll be talking the most about. With her, more of an opinion here, but I don't know if she really needed to be a full lace front. Just the way the style is. And everything. I mean, this all covers this up here. Don't get me wrong, lace fronts are more comfortable, they're more versatile, but I don't know. I just don't think it was really all that necessary with her. But I do like this spiky look a little bit with these layers. I think it's fun and wild, and that's part of the reason why I chose her. Something totally different than most of the other styles I get. Especially of a bob, you know? So I do like that. And if you take some gel, you could definitely do this to her and spike her up even more, which I might do. I'm considering it. If not today, at least some other time I will. But I think that that is really nice that you can have that versatility. I even mentioned that with Jarrett, that there were some different things you could do to her style. And obviously with Gemini, you can do the same. So far, Vivica A. Fox is at least taking that into consideration with her styles, that you can change them up a little bit. So that is nice. I really do like this color. I always have like this color combination, and just the way they have these 30 highlights in here, I think it's very pretty and unique. It's just right, the way they did the mixing of it. And this is a nice, true, rich number 4. That is pretty. Look at that luster too. Do you see it? Do you see it? That's the type of luster I'm looking for. She looks like healthy hair and she feels like it for sure. I mentioned before, with kinecalon fibers, you love it or you hate it. Hers, I think you will love. She feels soft and realistic. It's more of a silky texture, but I feel a little bit of coarseness in there. So really, this is a great multicultural unit. She's a good length too. I'm going to put her at 14 inches, smack dab underneath the chin, which is just right. I like how it curves in. It's one of the things I like about bobs. And I will show you her from the back. You don't have to worry about tangling with her. You know, this is the type of style. It's really not an issue. And shedding, I haven't noticed anything significant in that department either. Her density, you know, she's a little full, but that's really just the way the style is meant to be. But I think her density is actually appropriate. So this is one, I think, this piece though is driving me nuts, if you haven't noticed. But I think that this is the type of unit you could definitely get away with wearing to work. If you wear her with a nice cocktail dress or something, ooh la la. Yeah, that's going to be nice too, I think. So she's one that is for many different situations, which is also a good thing. And let me show you closer with her parting space. It's really narrow and it was hard to find, like I said, but I don't know. It's a little weird with the way the curve of it is. So I don't know, but it's not too bad. I mean, applying powder was really all I needed to do with it. And then the rest of the hairline here. See, this is why I didn't think it really needed to be a lace front. See? I don't know. Just my opinion. Obviously, thicker sides. A little bit of lift up. Not much. But, again, this is a style that covers it up. So it's really not that important. At least I don't think it is. She is comfortable, definitely larger head friendly, lots of stretchability and wiggle room with the cap. Comb placement, I think, is just right for her, having one by the part and one over on the side. It balances it out so you don't have too much in one area of lift up or anything. So I think she's comfortable and a good fit. I still recommend her. I mean, her quality is really good, other than the parting space. She's got it going on. I do. I think this is a fun style. A little classy too with the right outfit. Yeah. I'm giving her thumbs up. So I'm now had two wigs from Vivica A. Fox that I have liked. I need to go get more. I probably will. So anyway, and that is my review for her. I'm just going to probably go back and fix this piece a little bit more, maybe add a little bit more heat to it. But other than that, I think I'm going to leave her as she is, and I'll do that spiky look later. So that's all I got for her today. Don't forget to tell me your thoughts. Let me know if you have questions, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.